Hi guys, and welcome to another Tech Saturday with Eric and Keith. Today, we'll be installing the Nest Thermostat Generation 3. And also, with this latest generation of the Nest, they have like these remote sensors that are supposed to help regulate the temperature throughout the house. And that's, we also got that as an add-on here that we're gonna be installing as well. If you're new here, don't forget to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any of our awesome tech tips. If you want to see our playlist of what we got so far, we're up. This is video number 11.
Wow, dang, 11 already?
We're rocking this. But anyway, I'll link that playlist up here somewhere so you can check out the other videos if you're interested in this techie stuff. But if not, we also do travel stuff and vloggy stuff on Wednesdays. So check that out too. Okay, so, you know, we'll be installing these, but
doesn't look like my head. Where's the pops at?
We're not at Eric's house.
We're at Keith's house for this install.
I think this is the first Tech Saturday we've done at my house.
Yeah, definitely.
This is a first for Tech Saturday. Not necessarily the travel series, because we've done that a lot of times here in this office right behind me.
Yep.
Well, let's jump into it. Roll that intro. So, before we jump into this, I just want you guys to make sure of a few things. One, if you're not comfortable with this at all, places like Lowe's and Home Depot have installers that'll come out and do this for you. If you're not comfortable with this, definitely check that out. You are dealing with electricity, so if you're not sure what you're doing, you might want to be careful with this, okay? That's the first disclaimer here. Second, before you purchase this Nest, or any thing that you're going to be like replacing your thermostat with, check with the manufacturer to see if this is compatible with your system, because it might not be.
Yeah, you might have the older system. You don't want to spend a couple $100 on a smart device to find out that you had to return it because it's not compatible with your older heating system or whatever.
Exactly. So just make sure, and Nest makes it really easy. They have like a little wire checker. You just pop the face off of your existing thermostat, enter the wires that you have, and click submit, and it'll say yes, you're good, no, you're bad, or you might want to check with a professional. So
yeah,
definitely do that before you make any kind of purchase like this, okay? Alright guys, so you make sure you're comfortable with it, you know if your system's compatible with it. So now we're ready to jump into the instructions here.
Right, so your desk will come with an instruction manual.
The one thing I want to point out on the instruction manual is it actually has wire labels. So when you're taking off your wires from the old system and putting them on the new one, you can label what wire is plugged into what port on there. So, you know, because obviously you take a whole bunch of wires off, like, oh, I'm gonna totally remember this, and like 5 minutes later,
you might not remember.
I'm like, and another good suggestion too was to take a picture of where the wires were on your old system before you start this.
Definitely a good idea.
Okay, so you wanna show what the Nest actually looks like?
Yeah.
And before we get into showing you stuff, we're not really gonna officially do like an unboxing per se. We're gonna like show you the parts as we go through the installation here.
Right.
But just so you have an idea here, this is the Generation 3 Nest Learning Thermostat. Been out for a few years now, but this is a new finish they have. It's the stainless steel finish they have for it.
So that is the actual brains, but we need to install the little plate thing. It's got the wires, just plug the wires into here. It's got little buttons to push it down and push the wire in, and then it's retention. And the cool thing is it has like a little level. I don't know if you can see that, a little bubble level right here. So you know when we're installing it, you don't need to bust out a separate level to make sure it's straight on the wall.
I know, that's super handy because it's round. So it would be hard to like level that without the built-in level. So great job.
Uh-huh.
Great job, Nest.
So I guess now we're just gonna jump into the good stuff. But first things first, gotta shut that power off.
Shut that power off. That's the most important first step here, guys. Shut the power off. Okay guys, we're changing up locations. We're just over there. And now we're over here in front of the thermostat, but just wanted to let you know that we got the power off. The one thing to check for that is there's nothing on the display. Now, if you have batteries in it, take the batteries out just to make sure. But your thermostat should look like this. See how there's nothing on the display? You don't want anything on there. That's how you know the power's off to your device.
So what's the next step?
Okay, so the next step is we need to pull the cover off of our current thermostat to expose the wires that we have back there.
there right now, and then we will go ahead and unscrew the whole device from the wall and then start labeling our wires.
All right, let's do it.
Okay, guys, so most of these style thermostats, it just snaps on, so you just give it a small little tug here. It pops right off, and so obviously you see that our wires are right here on this one.
Okay, guys, and as you can see here, Eric's got his small screwdriver. You will need this. The one that came with the Nest is a little bit too big for my system, so definitely in your part of pre-plating, we should mention that you should definitely check, make sure you have all the equipment you need, such as this smaller screwdriver. But we'll go ahead and start pulling off the wires and label them here.
We'll start on this side and work our way across the terminal. Apply even pressure down and unscrew back, and you should be able to pull the wire right out.
Well, anyway, so this is our first sticker. It's W2. So we're going to go ahead and stick this right on. Okay. So then we're gonna move over. All right, guys, well, we're gonna like jump cut this here so you don't have to watch us install all these things, but you get the point. And we'll be back with you when we're on to the next step. Okay, guys, we got all of our wires labeled and they're off the leads there. And so now we're going to take the rest of the thermostat off the wall.
Should be two mounting screws in this one. There's one right here and one right here. And we got it out.
Okay, guys, so the next step was to align our mounting holes up. So we have our handy dandy level there. Just take a little pencil and draw in the hole so you kind of like mark where we're going to drill.
Okay, guys, they're just going to screw it in, do our little lead hole here.
Well, the good news is there's something solid behind there, so I'm glad we're pre-drilling. Okay, guys, so here's the faceplate that we're going to use because obviously behind it, as you saw, there was no paint. So we're gonna use this to cover that, which is probably how most installations are. But just wanted to let you know here that this is just gonna simply push onto this. And as you can see, we're good to go. You're just gonna screw your screws in through here. And that's what we're gonna do next. Okay, guys, and just so you know, like the wires have a little bit of a play in them usually, so you can pull them out. So this is what we had to do to scooch this over so that it covered up all the spot that was not painted. So we got that done and we got the holes pre-drilled and we're level. So Eric's going to sneak in here and just start our screws. Definitely do not set your torque too high on your drill because you don't want to break this. You just want it snugged up, and we got it snug. Okay, guys, so we got our labels. We restuck. It's really hard to get in there when it's so tight to the other terminal, so we just made sure we restuck them on. And so now we're going to install our wires onto the Nest, and you just follow the labeling. You just match like the G to the G, the Y to the Y. We chose Y1. The director said we could choose Y1 or Y2, so we put it in Y1. So you take the little lead coming out, give it a little straightening.
Push the button down,
and then you just push it in. You'll feel it kind of grab. So we got G in. So now our next one on this side is OB. I think, and then we have RC after that. So we'll just kind of push the excess cable back into the cavity here. OB, same thing. Move the label down on the wire, push it in, and that one grabbed right away. So I believe wires installed. We'll let you know how that goes. I think it was just that easy. Okay, guys, so the next step here is attaching our Nest. There's no tools, as you see. It's just sort of like it connects, just pushes right on and connects to the mount plate that we have here. So we're gonna do that now. And now we have it mounted. So the next step here is to go turn the power on. So we're gonna go do that right now. Okay, guys, and we're back. And look, we got power and the home thing's booting up right now. So the next step is to jump into the app and see what it tells us to do. All right, guys, as you can see, we're making some progress here. We had to take a small delay because it said in the app we had to scan the QR code, which is actually on the back. So before you push this on, scan the QR code on the back and then continue to the app. And also, if you're uncomfortable, the app actually has a walkthrough of all the steps that you need, we discovered. But we didn't have any problems. The only thing we had to fix was one of our wires was in the wrong port, but we moved that up according to the diagram on the phone, and now we're getting ready to set it up. Right now it's just updating the thermostat with a new software, so we'll be back in a second to continue the setup with you guys. Okay, guys, now as you can see, we finally got her all set up.
Okay, guys, so that was pretty easy. We had a few hiccups. We'll discuss that in a little bit, but moving forward, we're gonna finish the setup with our temperature sensors. So we'll jump into the app to show you how easy these are to set up.
Okay, so as you can see, we're in our Nest app, and we simply have to tap this gear icon in the upper right-hand side here. And then click this add product down here. Okay, we scan the barcode there, and it's wanting us to meet our temperature sensor, which is what we just scanned, so it's connecting it. So it added it to our Nest account. Click next. It says to pull the tab out of the battery, so we're doing that now. Next, so it's telling us to place it in a room we'd like to keep comfortable. But what we're going to do is we're going to take it upstairs and put it in one of the rooms. So we'll hop out of the app here, give you a quick little demonstration here in 1 second. Okay, we have it right here up in Lauren's room, as you can see. Jumping back in the app here, we just did the test of the connection, and as you can see, it's good. So we click next and give it a room. We'll call this Lauren's room. Next, install the temperature sensor. We can mount it on the wall or just put it on a flat surface. That's what we did. It's on a flat surface.
We're done with that one. We're not going to go through all of them with you. We're just going to do this 2 more times, and we'll be back with you pretty soon. Okay, so I'm going to hop back over here to the Nest to finish this out and show you what these sensors do, actually. So Eric's going to be the hand bottle here and going through this for us. But if you go up to the top here, to that one, to the active sensor, you'll see all these ones that we just set up, Lauren's room, master bedroom, and Nathan's room. And that what that's going to do is whichever one you select, like say Nathan's room, currently it's 73 in Nathan's room. So basically what this is good for, like, is if you sleep upstairs and no one's downstairs when you go to sleep, you set one of the temperature sensors up in your room, one of the rooms that we chose, and it'll keep the whole house at that temperature in your room. So like you set it to 71 upstairs, it'll stay 71 upstairs. You set it to 75, it'll stay 75 upstairs. But now that might mean the other areas are hotter or cooler, but it's all sort of based on where you are in the house type of thing. And that's sort of what this whole Nest thing does. Now, like Eric alluded to earlier, we'll tell you, like, that took a little bit longer than anticipated, probably real time, like maybe an hour instead of a half hour, like real time, right, just because we had to figure a few things out. And the main thing was, like, when we turned on the heating, it was actually cooling, but when you go through the app, you know, it shows you exactly where your wires should be plugged in, and our wires were plugged in exactly right. Well, the problem was there was like two types of heat pumps that you could choose. It was like B or O. And we had the O or whatever the common one was selected.
O was common.
And then it was like not that one. So when we switched that around, the heat kicked on and we've been fine ever since. That was the first problem.
The second problem was the auxiliary heat kept kicking on. Like, it's good, it shows you they have a heat pump, so you don't want to run auxiliary heat all the time because that'll be super expensive. Well, what do they do to fix that? You went to the settings and changed it to the balanced heat mode, so because it was on like most comfortable heat or whatever, most comfort, so like that was obviously trying to keep the house warmer, you know, so it was more comfortable. You can go even more into the savings with it, and I might try this out because there's like an extra savings one which would hardly ever probably use your heat pump, but we'll see. I'll let you know maybe in a future video. We'll do a how's the Nest doing a month later type of thing, you know. But for now, we got it all installed, we got the remote sensors installed, and we didn't do as much screen recording as I think we would have liked in this one.
There was a lot of login screens on the
there's a lot of like connect here, and then like my address, and then like my Wi-Fi stuff, and then it's pretty self-explanatory. I'll just say that I couldn't show that obviously, but the app is really easy. The Nest app made it super simple.
Oh yeah,
I liked how I had that diagram and everything.
Diagram would show you like what wires you had and then where to plug them in for sure. So, I mean, we knew where they were supposed to go, but you still kind of wonder if you were correct. So that ensures confidence in you.
Exactly.
That was correct.
Exactly. All right, guys. Well, if you got something on this video, make sure you like it. And if you're new around here, hit that subscribe button down below and drop us a comment. Let us know if you have any questions when you're going through the setup, because we might just know the answer.
Yeah.
Because we went through a lot with this thing. All right, guys. Don't forget to check out the links below, too, for the sweet merch we got going on here. And Patreon, if you want to become a Patreon, that would be amazing. Help us out, help the channel out, that would be awesome. And we'll see you guys in the next Tech Saturday in 2 weeks. Thanks a lot for watching, guys. Peace and love.